Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieku and today I want to show you a modeling technique that I use to model a shoe. Now, this is not a shoe modeling tutorial, although it will look like a shoe modeling tutorial because you can use this technique on many different kinds of objects, so it's not shoe exclusive. Anyhow, I'm not allowed to show you, unfortunately, the whole shoe and how it turned out, but I am allowed to show you a snippet of a shoe where you can kind of get the idea on how the whole thing turned out. So this is the shoe that I've been working on, and it's finished, of course, etc. So as you can see, it has a lot of funky curvatures, etc., and everything is just looking very smooth. So there was a special procedure to do that, and I want to share this with you. Why? I don't know, because it's, what is it today? Sunday. So I'm gonna be using the shoe from my previous video with the acquire modifier, and I'm just gonna generally show you how to model, for example, this frontal chunk. And that procedure was practically used for everything, and there's nothing more to it. So it was actually very straightforward. So for this whole technique to work, I first had to set up a base object, right? So just a raw base object of, you know, whatever I was going to model. And the most important part here is that that base object that you model, it needs to be as accurate as possible. And I don't mean, you know, like adding all the details and stuff, the proportions, just the proportions. Because as you can see here, this is how the model looks like, and this is enough. You just need to get the proportions right, otherwise you're not going to have a fun time. Next, we're going to be using two tools. One is called extend, one is called conform. And we're going to be using a bunch of modifiers, you're going to see. Anyhow, so this is the approach. You model your base object. It doesn't need to be a shoe, it can be like whatever you like. Then, I want to, for example, model this part. And as you can see, this part has stitches, it's under a curvature, so it's kind of, you know, like, kind of tricky. I'm just going to create a plane. It's just a simple plane. I'm going to convert it to editable poly. Next, we're going to be using two features. One is extend, and one is conform. What does extend do? Extend is a retopology feature, and it practically allows you to create polygons on existing surface. Conform is similar to our conform modifier. It basically presses the geometry onto different surface. So how are we going to use that? By the way, extend has a bunch of shortcuts, as you can see here, so you just need to kind of remember them. It's fairly easy to remember. It's just Alt Shift, Shift, Control Alt, etc. It's just those basic shortcuts. To get this whole thing started, I think by default this is on Draw on Grid, so you need to just switch on Draw on Surface, and there you need to pick on which surface are you gonna, you know, model. So in this case, it's my shoe, so it says shoe here. The offset here, the offset by default is zero. So what does that mean? Let me just go to my extend. So now I can just grab a vertex and place it here, take another one, place it here. If this offset, so the offset in the beginning, it was zero. And what does that mean? As you can see here, my vertex is slightly pushed away from the surface. When it was zero, it was completely pressing against the surface, and it was kind of hard to see what I was doing. So I like to have that at 0.5. Another thing when I'm modeling stuff like this, I always like to have this on. So go to edged faces here, for example, display selected, and click on display selected with edged faces. So what will that do? When you click that, and when you go into your shading mode without seeing the wireframe, the object that you have selected will always kind of be visible as a wireframe. So it's a very handy feature. So since the leather here goes underneath the strap here, just gonna place it, let's say, here and here, and I'm gonna place the starting points here. Extend is very cool. So look at this, you can just, you know, like extend stuff and, you know, do the whole modeling kind of thing. So you just roughly model, like generally low poly, model the whole shape of the shoe as you like it. I'm just gonna speed up this part a little bit. Okay, once I did this side, I'm just gonna toss a symmetry modifier. Okay, and now let me just align these points here the way they need to be aligned. Okay, let me just weld the front parts. Okay, so now I got this shape. And that's, you know, kind of the base of it. I'm just gonna add a couple of connects onto it so that it looks like this. And this is where our conform kicks in. So press on the conform, and the conform is literally a brush that's just gonna toss everything to the surface, and we got this. So this was my base for modeling. So how would I go from this part? Well, first I need to unwrap it. So I'm just gonna toss my unwrap, open UV editor, and just gonna switch to here to LSCM, Control A, to select everything and just reset. And we got this. Now this is our surface. I can just refine it a little bit, but that's it. Now I'm gonna run my lovely UV to mesh script. I'm gonna leave the link for the script in the description. So what will UV to mesh do? It will grab this UV island from the unwrap, and it's gonna actually project it in the viewport as an object. So look at this. You click on flatten from UV, so you got this duplicate here, which has a morpher modifier. And now when you go here and just raise this up to 100, you're gonna get that object morphing into the UV island that we saw earlier. Now there is one problem with this whole thing. Now as you can see, my shoe has, you know, a specific stitching. It has, you know, a specific distance from the edge, and the stitches are spaced, etc. Now here comes the cool part. My biggest problem with this is cool, you know, like this is on a flat surface. I can now model, you know, this whole object on a flat surface, but I don't actually see what I'm modeling and where I'm modeling, because there are these stitches here and they have, you know, like a specific spacing, and I just can't see here where that spacing is or how much things are spaced. So I had to find a way how I can possibly project this part of the texture onto this, because then I will see how things are done. And I have a way on how to do that. I don't know if it's the best way, but it's the best that I came up with. So it's this. I have this original part, right? I'm gonna go to my material editor. This is the texture that I've used for my shoe. I'm just gonna drop that texture onto it. And as you can see, the UVs are not perfect here, but there is this beautiful modifier, which is called project. So look at this, select the shoe, go to your modifier list and type projection. So this is projection. How does projection work? So you have your shoe selected. On your shoe, you have the projection modifier. You click on the pick button and you pick this object that we modeled. So I'm just gonna pick this, it appeared here. Now you just scroll down to the bottom and there is a projection rollout. Click that, just click the add button, and now scroll down a little bit more and just click project. And look at this. It looks like our object disappeared, where in reality it didn't. It just got the whole UV projected on it. Now there is another issue with this. So look at this. I have this as my UV. I'm just gonna add unwrap and just see how it looks like. And it looks like this. Why? Because that's just, you know, it's just taking the chunks from this texture. And for my flatten from UV to work, you know, to have the whole thing nicely laid out, I need to have a different UV. So what I did, I literally created two UV map channels. So how I did that, I just cloned this whole material. I've selected my texture here. I've set it to be map channel 2. Now I'm gonna go to my unwrap here, and I have everything selected here. That's fine. And I'm gonna move this unwrap information, the unwrap information that we have here, I'm just gonna move it to channel 2. Now you get this little warning and you just click move. So now this unwrap is in map channel 2. I'm just gonna convert that to editable poly, and I'm gonna add another unwrap on it. And this unwrap will be for our UV to mesh. So just gonna open UV editor, Control A everything, LSCM, reset, and just gonna rotate it like this. Hit unwrap here a couple of times. This is unwrap pro, so regular unwrap doesn't have that, but doesn't really matter. As you can see, because I redid the unwrap, I just have a different thing, but that's because the texture that we see here is our first material, which has map channel 1, and this one now has map channel 2. So if you just select that second material, apply it to the whole shoe object, you're gonna get the map channel 2 projection, which is exactly what we need. So this is a separate UV projection, and we have our unwrap here that's ready for our UV to mesh. So how do you go about it now? You click flatten from UV, we got this, and now when I push this to 100, I'm gonna get that surface laid out flat, and I can actually see where each and tiny little detail is. So now I can go and, you know, do all the crazy modelings. After I do my modeling, I'm just gonna toss a skin wrap on it, attach it to the morpher, and put it back in the shape. We're gonna see how it works. So for this scenario, I can just rework this, like rework this object for the whole thing to work. So how do you go? You just clone the object, you just collapse it. You don't need a morpher here because morpher is on the bottom object. And now I'm just gonna quickly remodel this part. I'm just gonna speed up this part of the video. Okay, from this point, I'm just gonna add the thickness of the letter, so it will be something like this. I'm just gonna cap the bottom surface and then do a small inset. Just don't want some parts to be messed up. Okay, this already feels messed up, but doesn't really matter. I'm just gonna delete that. This is solely because when I add Turbo Smooth, the deck, you can see nice curvature around the leather. All right, this is far from perfect, but you know, for the sake of the video, it will work. So now at this point, when we modeled, you know, our kind of object that we need, so I'm just gonna lower it down and kind of put it, let's say here, it's like in the middle of our morpher object, so this one, right, the one that bends to our original shape. So just gonna do that. Now on this, I'm just gonna delete my Turbo Smooth, and I'm gonna add skin wrap. Click on add, make sure that face deformation is on and weight all points is on. And once I did that, I'm just gonna select my morpher object and move this all the way down to the bottom. And we got this. Now from this point, I just, you know, can isolate that part and my shoe like this, and just move it and position it where the shoe is supposed to be. Let's say like this roughly. And yeah, collapse it from this point. You have your low poly, you just toss Turbo Smooth on it, and you got this part looking like this. And this is practically, you know, that part of the shoe. And you use that same procedure on absolutely everything. Just to say, you know, this was me rushing the whole object for the video. My topology is usually much cleaner than this, you know. But yeah, this is generally the procedure that I used to model, you know, the whole thing. And it was actually very fun. So you just literally just model chunks like that, then this chunk, then this chunk, then this chunk. And yeah, Acquire from the UVW map actually helped me a lot here. And you just assemble all the pieces together. What's important is that you have things in low poly here, so you're not dealing with some crazy high polys, you know, like straight from the start. And like, if you need to do any sort of, you know, like change or whatever, you can just, you know, go here and slightly just move things where you want them. And yeah, that's the procedure that I use. Extend, conform, projection modifier, etc. Finished up my shoe, which was looking like this in the end. And yeah, just wanted to share this method because you can use this on large variety of objects. Like when when a client sends you, you know, an object to model, you can just photograph it, project it on a, you know, like accurate avatar of the object, let's call it like that. And then you can just, you know, use the extend, conform, and just, you know, with the projection, you can just model things very, very accurately. And yeah, this is the modeling technique that I wanted to share with you guys. I hope it will help some of you to model some cool stuff. Of course, as usual, don't forget to check out Evermotion's website, because they have, you know, various offers. It changes very often, you know, always something is off somewhere, like 25% here, there, 50% there, you know. Plus, if you do not wish to spend cash, just browse things. Look, there's even this dude here that does tutorials, like this one and this one. I highly recommend you check his tutorials. He's awesome. And yeah, check out Evermotion's website. Enjoy your day and see you in the next video. Bye.